You're tuned in to Madden 18 on EA Sports. Anticipation is bouncing for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Bortles' Jaguars going up against Ryan's Falcons.
Thank you very much, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL, the National Football League, is here and on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars. And he motions the wide receiver. Bortles now on first down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And, oh, right away, he lost the football. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Well, he's going to have to shake out the cobwebs. First time he touches the football, and he drops it on the ground.
So many times we talk about quarterbacks and taking care of them early to get them in the flow with safe throws, right? But with a runner, there is no such thing as a safe run, right? Right out of the gate, you're going to be in some traffic. Got to take care of the ball, and he didn't do that.
For the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Second down following the run. Time running out here on the play clock. On second down, Freeman. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
The play clock's running down. Freeman again. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. On third down, Devontae Freeman. Freeman a first down and more. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, a 21-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. Here's Bosher to kick it away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the ball. Sean McVay deserving, I think you would agree, of Coach of the Year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what he did for the Rams when they went from last in the league in scoring to leading the league in scoring and winning a division title. And how about the New Orleans Saints?
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick, and he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Falcons taking over on offense in just a second, and, you know, this year ended in disappointing fashion now. Last year was the ultimate version of heartbreak, but if you're a Falcon fan, was this one was tough to swallow as well, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because let's be honest about it. Losing in the Super Bowl, I don't care how you lose, you're in the Super Bowl. You're playing for it all. This team was supposed to be as good or better. Ultimately ended up 10-6, found their way in the playoffs, but didn't get the deep run as they had the year before. So you're exactly right. For Falcons fans, that's a tough one. But this is a team that's built to be good for a long time.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Get up!
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. And now the Jags going to signal for another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. On third down, that's Coleman. Able to slither by. And some room to work. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Here on first down, he couldn't quite hold it, got hit, ball pops out, incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. And a nice little quick spin move before he's dropped. And a pretty good gain. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. On third down, that's Freeman. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you should have a few men in the box there.
Caught on the right side by Jones. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Looking deep for Gabriel, and this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Taylor Gabriel, 33 yards, and the Falcons will extend their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
I want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Grady Jarrett coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. Now Bortles throwing on second down. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. He rifles one that's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. And actually, Larry, hold that thought. We're right back to the action. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. On the return, here's Justin Hardy. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
On second down, here's Ryan. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. He's going to air one at. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Falcons. Taylor Gabriel, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about.
Like the way it sounds, Frody? Let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe. It's too hot, drop the top.